Okay, in this video we're going to show you how to create and explain everything presentation. So first we're going to locate our file in Dropbox. So you can see on the left here I've got all of my different documents. And then I've clicked on this one here, and then it's opened up over here. We can then press on this little arrow here, and that will make it go full screen. So you can see here, this is the full screen view, and I've zoomed up onto this section around here. Once you've zoomed up on your section, you're going to do a screenshot. So you can use the on-off button and also the home button on the front. You press them at the same time. You'll see that your screen flashes white, and that means that you've created a screenshot. And the picture will be put into your camera roll. So if you go to your camera here, with that little icon there, otherwise you can also go to your photos to locate it as well. Okay, so now we're opening up Explain Everything, and this is the first page that you'll see. If you've created a previous project before, there'll be something like this there. Otherwise it would just be blank, or it might have an example thing set up. So first thing we're going to do is press the plus button on the top left there, and that will allow us to create a new project. So you can see in this screen here, I've pressed that plus button, and I've set up these different templates. So I'm just going to select the white template here. That will just give me a white template background, and then it will give me the options of colours of black, red, and blue, but you can always change them later on. So once you have selected your template, you'll be given a blank screen like this one here. You've got your tools on your left-hand side. So this one here is the pen tool. That just allows you to draw normally. Okay, so we're going to add in a picture. So to add in a picture, we click on this symbol here, which is a page with a plus sign. And because we've already done our screenshot before, we can select the existing photo or video. Once you select the existing photo or video, you'll come up with all of your pictures which you have stored into your camera roll. So if they're all organized in albums, that's fine. You can sort, have a search through and find the ones which you need. Okay, so in this screen here, I've selected my image. So when I first selected my image, it'll just have the full page view. You can pinch and zoom to make it bigger. There's also some tools up here, at the top here, where you can use a lasso tool to draw around the selection you want. There's a crop tool, there's an undo button as well. Once you're happy with this selection, you can press the done button. So here I've used the crop button, and I've drawn around this section here, which will allow me to just have that little part as my picture. So here you can see that I've made the selection. This little checkered pattern around the background means that that's transparent, so that's not going to show up at all. And then this is my picture, just to make sure that you're happy with it. You can use those tools again if you want to refine your selection. If there's a little bit of text on the edge, you could use this tool here and just select around the outside. And once I press that done button, I will now have my picture, which is all set up in the background. Now, if you're having troubles with moving it around, you've got this little icon up the top left, which is a hand with the arrows, and that'll allow you to move it around. Otherwise, there's also on the left-hand side, around this sort of area here, a little eye button. So if you select on that one, you can actually lock it into the background, which will stop you moving it around if you want to draw over the top or anything like that. Okay, so I'm just going to select the pen tool here, which we spoke about before. If I tap and hold on it, it'll bring up this other menu, which can allow me to choose some different brushes. So I can have a hard edge one or a soft edge one. I can also choose the line thickness. The other tool here, which I've been using a lot for this presentation, is the laser pointer. So the laser pointer allows you to point like I've been doing. You can see that little dot that follows around. You can see it around here as well. I've done my screen capture. And then once you're finished with your presentation, you've recorded everything that you want to do, you have some different export options. So you select the export button here, which is a little movie strip with an arrow and a play sign. You can export it to the camera roll, so that will put it back into that camera icon which I showed you before. Or you can put it directly to YouTube, or you can export it to some of your cloud storage like Dropbox or Evernote, Google Drive, or a WebDAV solution. And that's the end.